LAZERfest, presented by Hard Rock Energy, giving you the energy to rock harder. And Laser 103.3.
All right, this is take two, hanging with the guys from Devour the Day, Blake, Joey, David, and Ronnie. All right, so let's try this again. Welcome back to town, first off.
Hey, thank you.
So you guys have been through the last time we figured, it wasn't the last time, but the Rock Girl pageant 2 years ago, where we crowned Rock Girl Haley Joe. And then you guys had come back and played Woolies again. And you were just talking about how you were at Woolies last night checking out some live music because you were in town a day early.
Yeah, we actually went out to see The Story So Far and
Four Year Strong
and Terror, which are all really, is a really good punk show. And the kids were just going crazy there. And Woolies is a great bar. And the arcade right next door.
Uptown, that's exactly what I was going to ask you. Did you get your Frogger on?
We didn't this time, but last time we... a night of drunk giant Jenga that went very late into the night. And, like, amazingly, we were playing so well, basically blind from alcohol. So it was good. It was a good time.
There's no fear when you're trying to play Jenga and you're half in the bag at that point in time, because if it happens, it happens. Whatever.
Yeah, no, I think more of the taunting dancing was the best. You know, everyone just really getting into talking smack, as it were.
Gives me a reason to make a loud noise, like, oh, it fell down.
Yeah. Again.
All right, you guys are going to be taking the stage at 6 o'clock tonight. Want to talk a little bit. There's a bunch of things that I want to hit on with you with, including we were talking off-air about you recording the brand new record. What can you tell us about the new record that's coming right now? I mean, because first you released Faith as kind of like a one-off and just kind of to get it out there, and now you're full into, you know, recording this record and kind of the process of this. Where are you guys at, and when are we going to see that officially in our hands?
I'll start off by saying that this is the first time in a long time that Joey and I have been in studio with a producer for an entire record, so we can make something that the relief of not having to worry about how to engineer a record and having a guy that is so good at it like Dan Cornith is. This record is, as we're making it, it's blowing us away because we're hearing it like, oh my gosh, this is the sound, this is exactly what we want to, this is the band right now, you know, we can hear it as a full group, and Ronnie came and played drums on it, and he did an amazing job, and bass tones.
Oh yeah. No, seriously, Dan Cornuff is, he's a very, very talented engineer for a long time, and then now taking over this producer ring, he just has been the most comfortable guy to work with I've ever been in whatever 12 years of making music. He really is incredible. And so the music that we made was built on what we do in our live show. A lot of times, because we aren't writing in a band setting, you write based on what feels good through the computer, maybe individually, and we kind of refused to do that. In fact, we did not do that at all. Every song had to be written within the world of the band room. And if we didn't figure it out as a full band the way that it should be, the way a garage band would, then it would get cut.
And
you'd be really amazed what sounded great to you going into the session with 58 songs, and you come out with 11 because you start to play those in the band room and you realize that they just don't translate the same way when you go to play it. And that's that realness is what we were after.
Well, it's that and kind of like you said before, that human connection as well, where everybody's in the room, everybody's going to feel for what that song sounds like and how you see how each of you react to it, as well as that other set of ears by tying into the producer this time around.
Yeah, and it's a lot better than just everyone sitting around staring at, like, trying to figure out a riff. And it's like, well, what if it's like... J-j-j-j-j-j-j. No, I think it should. No, like, how about Jun 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 Jun? Yeah, yeah. And not that that's how the record says, but sounds. But you know what I mean. Like, it felt so much better to just organically move throughout, you know, the navigation of each of these songs. And I've never been more proud of any music that we've made than I am of this record. It's awesome.
So tell me about how Faith came about.
Faith was Blake and I. We've gotten asked a lot if we are, quote unquote, religious band, if we're a Christian band, or and I think in some ways it was a reaction to that, but also talking about being 14 years old, music changing your life, and that's actually what was a savior for you, was the music. And I mean, Blake, you can expand.
I think most people have those moments where you know, they're in high school or they're at any age where you're 15 or 55, where you hear something that actually changes the way that you feel about your life. And you're like, oh my gosh, my life is not that bad because this guy is saying exactly how I feel. And music has done that for me constantly, over and over. And everybody up here, you know, and everybody listening right now knows that there are songs out there that they can relate to a specific place and time because their wife disappeared on them, or you know, for whatever reason. It doesn't matter. It's just that music had a way of connecting with you and pulling you out of your funk and getting you back on your feet. And realizing that there's tomorrow and that, you know, other people feel the same and they're still going, they're still happy, you know, and why can't I do the same thing? And that song is a description of the way that music did that for Joey and I at a very young age.
And let's talk about real quick how the recording of Faith is now kind of worked into the new record, because we were talking off air that kind of came first, and then the decision to go on and do the full record kind of after the fact with more partners involved, correct?
Yeah, and for us, it couldn't have happened a better way, just because we literally proclaim our love for our music, how we're going to make our music, and demonstrated really to everyone what we intended on doing with our sound as we move forward. And it responded into a new deal, into working with a wonderful producer, and there's so much risk involved in that, but for us, it's just the irony that we literally took this leap of faith with a song called Faith, and I think that's a beautiful twist of fate for us, and it continues to work that way, and we just feel really happy that we have this opportunity to take the bull by the horns again.
So does the new record officially have a title yet?
It does officially have a title.
Hasn't been announced yet.
All right,
I know. I was going to try to get something out here. Does it officially have a release date yet?
No, but I will say it'll be sometime late fall.
Okay, so this also kind of plays into everything else, because you're kind of doing a little bit of studio time, but you're also just about to go out. Of course, you're doing LAZERfest today, but you're also got another tour coming up with 3 Days Grace and Finger 11, and that kicks off at the end of June, right?
Yep.
Yeah, which we're really excited about.
Yeah, because they're great guys, and they have to be invited out again for us. You know, we toured with them a little bit last year. And they're great guys. Great, it's a lot of fun. Great crowds.
Well, who knows? Maybe fingers crossed. We get you here today. Maybe we get you later on this summer.
May or may not.
You never know. All right. Thanks to the guys for Devour of the Day. They are taking the stage at 6 o'clock tonight. Let's do up their latest. It is called Faith at Laser 103.3.
LAZERfest, presented by Hard Rock Energy, giving you the energy to rock harder. And Laser 103.3.